Li and Li continues to impress us with their brand new chassis constantly emerging on the market. And today we have a better and improved case, the Lenkul 2. This one right here is the Lenkul 2 mesh. So let's dive in, check out all the details about the case. What's the difference between the Lenkul 2 and the Lenkul 2 mesh? I had actually the same white version. So yeah, we have loads to talk about. Let's go. So this is how you get the case with three ARGB fans. It's a bit strange they are black because the whole chassis is white, but then again, if you take into consideration that they have white and black version and performance and the RGB version, it's kind of normal. So for the performance version, you get two 120 millimeter fan on front which aren't RGB and one at the back, and when it comes to RGB version, you get three right on front. The cool thing about it and what they did, comparing it to the Lenkul 2, is they placed the complete front side in mesh. And not only that, they placed the power supply shroud also in mesh. Now what they said and what they stated is that this helps the GPU get more air if you place on your power supply shroud two additional 120 millimeter fans. Now, since I placed the Li and Li Streamer Plus cables for the graphic card, I don't think you would be able to place two fans just because of the stiffness of the Streamer Plus cables. But it's really cool because if you don't want to place any fans, you can place two 2.5 inch SSDs right here on the power supply shroud. And that's also an addition, which is really cool. Now, the one thing I said that I really love about the Lenkul 2 is the possibility to mount your three 3.5 inch hard drives. As you can see, it's fairly easy. And in addition, you can get the hot swappable tray, basically place it at the back and switch your hard drives. This is really nice to have. For instance, there's loads of space for everything here, for the power supply, for the cables, and then you can place three 3.5 inch hard drives for a hot swappable possibility and for some crazy ride fields if you decide. Let's go to something even further. Now, usually the one thing that sticked from the Lenkul 2 is opening the tempered glass. You don't have any possibility, let me just do it like this a bit, you don't have any possibility to open the tempered glass without opening the bottom part of the power supply shroud. But still, if you manage to do it quite nicely, it's actually not bad to open the power supply shroud and then open the tempered glass. The one thing, it's really nice to have the possibility to close it magnetically, and it really fits nice without any difference in the hinges and the edges, and you can easily pop out the tempered glass just by removing it from the original hinges that are placed on the case. Placing it back is also very easy, and there you go. Now, the components that I used inside is MSI RTX 2080 Super Gaming X Trio, which fits quite nicely even with the 360 radiator on front, the 10700K on the ASRock Z490 Steel Legend, and 360 radiator on front, which cools quite nicely. Now, taking into consideration that we have a mesh front right here, it's more like perforated steel with holes and no mesh to and no fill and no dust filter, just because it will create additional air blockage. but this way they did it really nicely. Under 100% load with AIDA 64, the 360 cooler on front did a nice job and giving it 66 degrees on 10700K on a stress test. So basically I was torturing the CPU for a half an hour, and first it kind of had loads of peaks on the temperature going up to 74, and it stabled around 66-67. Now let's continue with the case and the design. Now you know that the temperatures are quite all right. The GPU is also quite nicely cooled with direct intake from the front. The perforated power supply shroud actually does create additional intake, just because if you place the fans on the power supply, it can take the air right here from the side and directly to your graphic card. Extra cooling for the graphic card, which we didn't have in the Lenkul 2. Now, as for the cable shroud on the right side of the motherboard, it's versatile, so you could flip it and then basically place an E80X motherboard without having issues with the cables. This way it doesn't fit when it's originally placed, as it comes right from the box, but if you flip it around, you can place the E80X board and cables nicely arranged, even the SATA cables and the front USB 3.0. Next to that, you have the possibility to rearrange the hard drive cage as you wish, just like the Lenkul 2. Lenkul 2 mesh also has the possibility to slide the whole cage, and basically removing it, you do need to remove the front panel, fans, and then just pop it out from the front side. On front, you have the possibility to adjust the colors and the mode of the addressable RGB parts inside the case if you connect them properly. You have the reset button and the power button, 3.5 millimeter jack for your headset and for your microphone, two USBs 3.0, and you have additionally possibility to place the USB Type-C that you need to buy separately. Now, Lenkul 2 and Lenkul 2 mesh can be nicely equipped with the vertical GPU kit, and it's really nice just because you don't have to cut out the side part for the vertical mount. It covers all the PCI slots that are here inside the case, and you don't have extra dust coming in. It just makes a nice width, of course, with the riser, so it creates a nice vertical mount for your GPU if you decide to go with it. And especially in the Lenkul 2 mesh, if you place your GPU vertically, you can have a nice intake from the perforated part of the power supply shroud. Also, you could do with the side diffused LED strip, you can do a nice RGB effect right here above the power supply shroud, so it does look even nicer and it gives a nice effect, like all around RGB or single color or everything that you desire. Now, when we're talking about the backside, it basically is the same as the Lenkul 2. There's no difference because you don't have a perforated steel plate right here. It's just a plain plate where you can remove it the same way as the front side. You do have the possibility to place two 2.5 inch SSDs, and as you can see right here, this is where you place all the cables. But here is another thing, you have a possibility for two additional 2.5 inch SSDs right here, and the plates that cover all the cables, making it easier for you to close the panels. This is very important, even though the case does have a lot of space for the cable management at the backside. This is really nice to additionally regroup the cables and place them in different sections depending on how you use it. Talking about some different things, like the magnetic parts on the bottom power supply shroud covers, on the Lenkul 2 they were just pure magnet touching the steel plates on the case and making an additional noise. Now they did something different and adding some sort of a dampening pad that kind of, when you place it, it doesn't crash that bad. And yeah, we finally have a decent case, even though I'm not dissatisfied with the Lenkul 2. It still did an amazing job, but all the functions that Lenkul 2 had, they transferred it to Lenkul 2 mesh, adding the front fully perforated panel, which gets more air intake inside, opening the power supply shroud with the same way they open the front panel, giving enough intake for the graphic card and basically managing this. So the whole computer, the whole build looks really nice if you combine the colors as you wish, of course if you have a specific theme, but even the design looks great altogether. On top you have a dust filter, which is magnetic as you can see, and you have loads of possibilities for the fan configuration, because you can place two 120, two 140, or you could even place, and you can manage a 240 radiator on top, giving you loads of possibilities for the radiator clearance. On front you have the 360, 280 and 240 radiator possibility to mount it, which is quite alright. I mean, you have two ways of doing the radiator support for cooling and then basically doing a custom loop inside, which is always a cool thing for you guys that like to experiment with your cases and builds. All in all, very satisfied with the temperatures, very satisfied with the case and what they did and how they improved from the Lenkul 2 to Lenkul 2 mesh, keeping all the main bits and pieces of the original case and adding extra stuff. So guys, first of all, PC Crazy performance badge, then PC Crazy Best Buy badge, just because it's a €90 case, and there isn't even any difference between performance and RGB version. So Lee and Lee decided that RGB isn't something better than the performance. Basically, performance badge, Best Buy badge, and approved badge. This is actually the first product on my YouTube channel that I decided to give three badges, and this case definitely deserves it. So Lee and Lee, thumbs up from me for this case. Lee and Lee Lenkul 2 mesh, guys. Links are below if you decide to check it out. I don't know else what to say. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to click the thumbs up button and don't forget to subscribe for future videos. And that's all there is to it. Bye bye.